When we talk to each other, explain our symptoms to the doctor, or exchange any kind of personal information, we are sharing human data. Human data is useful when we want to understand how diseases or illnesses affect people. If we want to understand if exposure to chemicals or contaminants affects human health, we would ideally use human data. An example of human data is randomized controlled trials, which involve small groups of volunteers, and any effects that they experience are usually minor and reversible. Such trials are often used to test the effects of medicines, and they can provide the best evidence linking a stressor to a health effect. However, this approach, which essentially involves carrying out experiments on humans, is often not an option because of ethical concerns. The alternative to experimenting on humans is to experiment on animals, that is, in vivo testing. Another option is experiments on cells in test tubes, called in vitro testing. The use of animal studies is well established in the scientific research and is crucial in areas like testing exposure to pesticides. But animal studies have limitations. In particular, some symptoms such as headaches or certain neurological diseases are difficult to detect in animal experiments. So what else can we do? Epidemiological studies describe and analyze patterns of diseases in humans. They can statistically evaluate an association between exposure to a substance and health outcomes in humans. Unlike clinical trials, these studies are based on observations, not interventions. When the evidence from observational studies is statistically powerful, confident conclusions can be drawn. A good example is the strong link between smoking and lung cancer. However, the big drawback is that in observational studies, the researchers do not control the environment in which these observations take place. For example, a study might show a link between consumption of red meat and cancer, but this does not demonstrate cause and effect. The red meat eaters may also be heavy smokers, and other lifestyle factors might be at work. The big advantages of epidemiological studies is that they involve humans. The disadvantage is that these studies are not conducted in a controlled environment. Animal studies, on the other hand, are carried out in controlled conditions and should produce unambiguous results. But those results cannot always be used to predict effects on humans. Several lines of evidence should always be evaluated. And when they converge, our certainty about scientific findings is increased. In other words, animal and human data should be seen as complementary, not mutually exclusive.